bulletin, in the right-hand corner, you'll see our mission statement, which is worship, grow, serve, and go. A vision statement, I should have said vision statement, is how we live out our mission statement. Every church in the denomination of the United Methodist Church, our mission statement should be to make disciples, to know Christ and to make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, which is a great commission. But how we live out our mission statement is our vision statement, which is worship, grow, serve, and go. Last week we talked about worship. This week we're going to talk a little bit about growing and what that could look like and how to grow. One of the things that I asked from some people last week is to pray for this mission statement and our vision statement, and we have a sign of Sheba, I believe, over there. If you're willing to give us like some time during the week to pray for this, we don't know exactly how that will look, and we'll let you know. But it may even just be praying from home if you could give us some time to pray for that. But if you're going to live out something that God wants us to do, prayer is an important backing on that. So, with that said, I don't know about you, but I'm always wanting to grow, and I'm always wanting to see more of God. Take a look at this. Something else that I have tried to do over the years is A good exercise program. Does anyone else try to do that too? An exercise program? When I was at my first appointment down in Johnsonburg, Pennsylvania, I joined the Y in Ridgeway, PA. And I would go there at 6 a.m. to work out. And one of the reasons why I went there so early is for me, when I do a workout in the first part of the day, it gets me energetic and the day seems to flow a little bit better when I exercise. The other reason why I go really early to a gym like that is because I'm pretty much a klutz when it comes to working out. There was one time that I was working out with this piece of equipment and I went later in the day because I couldn't go one day. And I saw someone actually using the equipment, right? And the other thing is, there was also an unfortunate underwear incident of 2006 when I was at seminary. And you'll have to ask me about that sometime. I'm not going to talk about that here in church. Nothing pornographic, but really embarrassing. Phew. So I tend to go when it's less populated. Lately, I've been using a streaming device that is kind of like a Netflix for workouts that comes right to my computer, and I do it at home. And I have heard that most accidents happen in the kitchen, so I work out in the living room. But there are some things that I have learned in these workouts that have helped me to grow, to change my body, hopefully, in some ways, and to learn to be in better health. And I thought I'd share some of those things with you this morning. The first thing that I have learned is that it is important to pay attention to what you eat. It's important to watch what you eat. Now, I am not incredibly disciplined with that as of late, but I have been in the past. And when you are disciplined to what you eat, it really makes a difference. One of my workout programs says in one of the workouts, you can undo everything in your workout in the kitchen. So it's important to pay attention to what you eat. Reese's cups and Pepsi do not help you get in good physical physique. Now, one of the other things that I have learned with exercising is it's important on how you breathe. There's a real inclination or a temptation when you're doing crunches to hold your breath. I've done that. But if you inhale and exhale when you are exercising, it becomes a lot easier. You don't tire out so much when you're doing the routines. So eating and breathing are important when you exercise, important when growing a healthy physique. The third thing that I want to draw our attention to this morning when we're exercising is that we must exercise if we're going to do that. How many of you have bought treadmills that have turned into clothes racks? Have you done that before? We buy a piece of equipment or a workout program, or maybe you have a gym membership that is not seeing any use right now, or that DVD that you got to work out with, you have no idea where it's at right now. It's somewhere in the house. Well, one of the most important things in the exercise program is actually to exercise. It's the exercise program. And one of the most important things too is a certain word, and that word is today. Now, I tend to do this when I exercise. I think, well, I'll do a better job tomorrow, you know? But you know what? Tomorrow is never here. It's important to do it today. And maybe even a better word when we're exercising is the word now. So it is important to do it now. So eat, breathe, and exercise are important when we're trying to get into better shape. Now, again, I was talking about this mission statement that we have been looking at, this vision statement that we have here in our bulletin. Worship, grow, serve, and go. And this week, we're looking at grow. What does it mean to grow? And we are looking at a scripture passage found in the book of Ephesians this morning. It's a prayer that Paul prays for the people of Ephesus. And he writes this letter called the Ephesians. And the Ephesians were a group of people that were struggling with things like racism, like the Jews and the Gentiles. They were also talking about parental struggles with the children and their parents. And if you look at the end of Ephesians, you'll see that it was talking a lot about spiritual warfare. So Paul was trying to address the big line that divides people in this book. And he's talking about the love of Jesus, because the love of Jesus is going to help a lot out with those divisions. And it's going to be one of the imperative things. The love of Jesus is the answer for most of our human problems, I believe. And this is what he prays. It's from the book of Ephesians, chapter 3, starting with verse 14. If you're able to, as we look at this biblical message this morning, stand as I read it for us. And it reads like this. The Apostle Paul says this, "For this reason I kneel before the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth derives its name. I pray that out of his glorious riches he may strengthen you with power through his Spirit in your inner being, so that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith. And I pray that you, being rooted and established in love, may have power, together with all the Lord's holy people, to grasp how wide and long and high and deep is the love of Christ, and to know this love that surpasses knowledge, that you may be filled to the measure of all the fullness of God. Now to him who is able to do immeasurably more than all we ask or imagine, according to his power that is at work within us, to him be glory in the church and in Christ Jesus through all generations, forever and ever. Amen." This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
You may be seated. Now, the Apostle Paul, if you look at this, he prayed that the people would be able to grasp how wide and long and high and deep is the love of Christ. This love of Christ is cute. It is perfect. It covers every area, every dimension. The width implies God's Christ's worldwide love. It is very wide, embracing all men. Length is this knowledge is extends through all ages, through all generations. Depths refers to its profound wisdom, which no creature can fathom. The height is being his love being beyond the reach of any foe to deprive us of it. The love of Christ is perfect, and it is what we need to fix a lot of the things that are wrong in this world. And Paul prays that the Ephesians will find it. And you know what? This is a prayer that I pray for us today. It's a prayer that's very applicable to us as well today. That we will find, that we together, we will find this love. Paul tells us how to obtain this love in this passage. If we really want to grow in this knowledge, it is right there this morning. Look at it with me. Look at verse 16. It says, "I pray that out of his glorious riches he may strengthen you with power through his Spirit in your inner being." First, we must rely on God's Spirit. And to do this, we will need to get focused. Now, how do we grow strong in the Spirit? Well, kind of very similar. I'm going to use the same things that we talked about when we exercise. First, we need to eat. We need to breathe, and we need to exercise. But first we must eat. We must devour the Word of God. Look at these passages. It says, "The Spirit gives life, the flesh counts for nothing. The words, Scripture, I have spoken to you, they are full of the Spirit and life. They give us nutrients." And then also Jeremiah 15:16, "When your words came, I ate them. They were my joy and my heart delight. For I bear your name, Lord God Almighty." We must know the Word of God. We must eat it. We must devour it so that we can become strong. Are you in the Word? Maybe a good Bible study could help you when it comes to the Word of God. Or maybe a good study Bible. Talk to me if you need to know more about your diet with the Word of God. When it comes to the Word of God, how healthy is your diet? Secondly, we must breathe. We must pray continually. Look at these passages from 1 Thessalonians 5:17. It just says, pray continually. And then also from Philippians 4:6, it says, do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God. How's your prayer life? Are you praying? When we pray, we are breathing and handing things over to God. Kind of like when we're breathing, when we exercise, it makes things a little bit less frustrating. It makes it easier to do the exercise. It makes life a little bit easier when we're breathing and handing those things over to God by our prayers. Are we handing the things over to God? The third thing is that we need to exercise. Look at this passage of Scripture. It says, he said to them, go into all the world and preach the gospel to all creation. You know, I have to admit to you, I hate to exercise. I really do. The sprawls, the deep knee bends, the jumping. But just like physical exercise, spiritual exercise is important too. Go into all the world. When was the last time you were doing God's work? How much are you exercising? It's important to do God's work. We see people in this church doing it. Sometimes I hear people say, I have family commitments. Well, maybe the family is who you're supposed to minister to. You have other things like a job and stuff. Are you doing things for the glory of God? You know, we need to be exercising. So these things, the Word, the prayers, and service, can help us get stronger in the Spirit. But the funny thing is, this is how the Spirit works through us too. We just need to be open to it and plug into the power by doing these things. Word, prayer, and exercise. Also, we must be doing these things in love. Just look at the Scripture. We must be rooted and established in love. Now, this could be an entire sermon all by itself, being rooted and established in love. And this has to be the agape love of God, who loved us enough to give us his Son. This love needs to be grounded in Jesus. Our motivation should be that of Jesus Christ, who came not to be lifted up, but to be a servant to all. So this is how we should grow. And I believe that if we sought to grow like this, in a physical way, like I said at the beginning, to eat right, to breathe, and to exercise, we would have a healthier body. I also believe that if we indulge in the Word of God, breathe the prayer of the Spirit, and exercise in Christian spirit, we would be strengthened. And if that is all rooted in love, we would be a healthier body together. And we as individuals as well. And a body would grow and begin to see how wide, how high, how deep, and how long is the love of Jesus. We would grow. Amen. Let's pray. Lord God, as we think about growing today, we pray that we would just remember these simple things of being in your Word, eating, devouring your Word so that it becomes a part of us. That we would be breathing, that we would be praying continually to you our everyday life, and that we would be exercising, doing the work of God. We pray that we would be able to to do those things so that we start to grasp how high and wide and deep and long is the love of Christ. We pray this in your name.